this video, I want to begin talking about structures related to the respiratory system. Now, normally when we talk about the respiratory system, people think lungs. But the respiratory system actually starts at the nose as well as the mouth as we pass air through the nasal cavity and the oral cavity and down to the lungs. So let's start with this half-head model and talk about some of the structures related to the respiratory system. Obviously, we have the nose with the nostrils. The nostrils are known as the nares, and more specifically, the external nares. And we know that we can breathe through the nasal cavity or the oral cavity, but let's focus on nasal cavity for now. Within the nasal cavity on this model, we can see three areas on the lateral aspect of the nasal cavity known as the concha, or the turbinates, the inferior, the middle, and the superior nasal concha and nasal turbinates. Now technically the bones that cause this rolling areas are the concha. When we put the soft tissue on, they become known as turbinates. So we have an inferior, a middle, and a superior nasal concha. Those help to roll the air as the air passes through the nasal cavity. That does two things for us. Actually three. It allows us to humidify the air with the moisture in the nasal cavity. If we're breathing cold air, it helps to warm the air with the heat of the nasal cavity. And it also causes the air to swirl, which basically centrifuges the air so that dirt particles will get thrown to the sides of the nasal cavity so they can stick to the nasal mucus. After we pass through the nasal cavity, we enter what is known as the nasopharynx, the posterior portion of the nasal cavity. And from there we will go down through the oropharynx and then into the laryngopharynx. And at this point we're going to see a division between respiratory and digestive system. Digestive we will pass down through the esophagus, a muscular tube leading to the stomach. But in respiratory, we're going to pass through the area of the larynx. And here we can see several different features. We can see the epiglottis, a flap of cartilage that will seal across the top of the larynx during swallowing, so food cannot go through the larynx and the trachea. And we can see the laryngeal cartilage and the first ring of the trachea known as the cricoid cartilage. We can also see in the lateral wall of this model the vocal folds, the true vocal fold and the false vocal fold. The superior one is the false vocal fold. The inferior of these two is the true vocal fold. So some of the structures related to the respiratory system within the head.